Moin, alle Guten. Ich bin Dan, der Prof von Luxemburgisch with Anne. Welcome to this new lesson. In this lesson, you will learn 15 useful verbs which always take the dative case. Bist du bereit? Are you ready? Dann los! First, if you want to make a correct sentence with a dative verb, you will need to know the personal pronouns in the dative case as well as the articles. Let's repeat the personal pronouns in the dative case. So to say me or to me in Luxembourgish is mir. You or to you is dir. Him or her is him. Yes, for her, informal is him as well. Now, for her, formal is here. Now, us or to us is eyes. You or to you in the plural or formal form is ears. And them or to them is hinnen. Okay, great. Now, briefly, the articles in the dative case. So the masculine article is dem. So this is the definite article. The neuter definite article in the dative case is as well dem. The feminine definite article is da, and pronounce it da. And the plural definite article is den, den. And den is subject to the N rule because the word ends in N. Okay, great. Now let's get started with the 15 verbs. Okay, I have chosen commonly used verbs which will be very useful for your daily conversations. Let's start with the first one. Antworten. Let's practice the pronunciation. So listen to me and repeat after me. Antworten. Good. Okay. So in this video, I will give you for each of these 15 verbs one example sentence. But on my blog, I have put the link under this video, you can find two examples for each verb. Okay. And you can download the PDF copy. So, let's start with one sentence with the verb entfernen. Kannst du mir entfernen? Let's repeat. Kannst du mir entfernen? And how would you say, can you answer him? Hopefully you've got, kannst du him entfernen? And can you answer her? Informal would be as well. Kannst du him entfernen? Verb number two is bleiben. Let's repeat. Bleiben. Ich bleibe bei dir. And how would you say I stay with them? Yes, this is ich bleibe bei ihnen. Great. Verb number three. Fehlen. Fehlen. Was fehlt ihr dann? So this is the first question a doctor may ask you when you go to visit a doctor and you are not feeling well. He would say, was fehlt ihr dann? And then, gefallen. Gefallen. Example, Luxembourg gefällt mir immens gut. Or if you want to say that they like Luxembourg very much, or Luxembourg is pleasing to them very much, would be Luxembourg gefällt ihnen immens gut. You've got it? Great. Let's move on with the next verb. Gehören. Gehören. Gehört ihr staat? So here it is the formal form of you. How would you say the same sentence with the informal form of you? Yes, this is gehört dir dat? Gehört dir dat? Next verb. Geschehen. Geschehen. The past participle of geschehen is geschieht. So you can ask someone, wat aus dir da geschieht? Wat aus dir da geschieht? And if you want to use the formal form of you, you would say, wat aus ihr da geschieht? Wat aus ihr da geschieht? As you can see, often in questions, we use the word dann, which often loses the two final M because of the N rule, and you will hear da. And I have a separate lesson to explain why we use dann in questions. Let's move on with the next verb. Gin, gin. For example, kannst du mir Salz gin, wann ich gelift? Kannst du mir Salz gin, wann ich gelift? Gleven, let's repeat, gleven. Ich gleven dir dat net. That's the informal form of you. And if you want to say this to more formal, you would say, ich gleven ihr staat net. Ich gleven ihr staat net. Helfen, helfen. Kann ich ihr helfen? Now, this is the first question you might be asked when you enter a shop in Luxembourg. Kann ich ihr helfen? Next one is schmachen. Schmachen. So, for example, you are in a restaurant and you are about to eat your dish. Then the owner or the waiter can ask you, schmachtet ihr? Schmachtet ihr? In the sense of, do you like it? Does it taste? Is it tasty, for example? Good. Soen. Soen. Ich muss da Madame Weber etwas soen. So here you have da. Da is the definite feminine article in the dative case. Ich muss da Madame Weber etwas soen. Now, how would you say the same sentence with Mr. Weber? Hopefully you've got ich muss dem Herr Weber etwas soen. You got it? Great. And then, vertrauen, vertrauen. Du kannst mir vertrauen. Du kannst mir vertrauen. Next one. Verzeihen. Verzeihen. Ich werde dem Pol dat nie verzeihen. Ich werde dem Pol dat nie verzeihen. Weisen. And pronounce it weisen. Können dir eis de Plan weisen? Können dir eis de Plan weisen? And then the last one. Weidoen, weidoen. Hust du dir weigedoen? Hust du dir weigedoen? Weigedoen is the past participle of weidoen. Great. And now it's time for the Übung, exercise. I will give you three sentences in English and you will try to translate this into Luxembourgish. And why not putting your answers in the comments below this video and I will give you my feedback. Don't forget that you can download the full transcript with more examples on my blog. And on my blog you have access to more than 80 or 100 lessons so that you can improve your Luxembourgish. So, prêt? Good. Sentence number one. You must answer her today. You must answer her today. Sentence number two. Can you give him your phone number? Can you give him your phone number? And the last one. Wait a moment. I will help you. Wait a moment, I will help you. Great, now I'm looking forward to reading your answers. Merci fürs Zuschauen. Thank you for watching. Adi!